Olo is described as a new color that scientists argue they've enabled people to see, one that doesn't resemble anything in our everyday visual experience. It's described as an intensely saturated greenish blue, brought to life using a new technique that stimulates the eye's photoreceptors in a non-conventional way. But can this really be considered a novel color like the researchers boldly claim? The three components of color are hue, saturation, and value, or brightness. The study suggests Olo appears with a uniquely strong saturation, but its hue remains firmly in the grasp of blue-green. Anyway, we'll leave that debate for the color scientists and the comments section for now. Regardless of the definition, those who've seen Olo say it offers a visual experience that's subtly unfamiliar. Participants report that Olo appears blue-green of unprecedented saturation when viewed relative to a neutral gray background. They find that they must desaturate Olo by adding white light before they can achieve a color match with the closest monochromatic light, which lies on the boundary of the gamut, unequivocal proof that Olo lies beyond the gamut. Color names volunteered for Olo include teal, green, blue-greenish, and green, a little blue. Participants consistently rate Olo's saturation as 4 of 4, compared to an average rating of 2.9 for the near monochromatic colors of matching hue. Color is a perception that we experience when certain wavelengths of electromagnetic radiation stimulate the cone cells in our retina, sending signals to the brain. Coating the back of our eyeball, we have three types of cone photoreceptors: short wavelength, middle wavelength, and long wavelength, each with overlapping spectral sensitivities. Because of this overlap, any given light wavelength stimulates at least two types of cones simultaneously, which limits the range and saturation of colors that we can perceive. In a new study, scientists at the University of California, Berkeley have developed a way to directly stimulate a single cone by blasting it with a focused laser light, called OZ. Using this system on five human subjects, the laser system was able to solely trigger M cone cell activity, leading people to report experiencing a color described as blue-green of unprecedented saturation. They were able to wield this technique to stimulate thousands of individual cones, allowing them to create images and visuals with the technique. Traditional color technologies, like the computer screen you're currently looking at, rely on a method called spectral metamerism. This involves blending different wavelengths of light to mimic the way our eyes perceive specific colors, prompting the cone cells in our retinas and our brains into seeing a match. This strategy has been around since at least 1861, when James Clerk Maxwell wowed audiences at the Royal Institution by layering red, green, and blue images to create full-color visuals. The OZ method uses a different approach. Rather than adjusting the spectrum of light, it controls the spatial distribution of light on the retina, a concept known as spatial metamerism. This allows for the creation of a broad range of colors using a single monochromatic light, sidestepping the need for the three light primaries. Experts acknowledge that while the research introduces some promising practical innovations, some aspects of single-cone stimulation are not entirely new.